But it was, I just wanted to talk about friendship. And this was a script that I'd originally written many years back.
Khel khel me. Khel khel ke. Khel khel ye aa jayega.
It is about these two unusual characters, the chess grandmaster and the ABS officer, coming together. And the grandmaster actually explaining to the young man what friendship is all about, what love is all about, what sacrifice is all about, what relationship is all about.
Wazir was a different ballgame altogether, because there was one a massive chunk of VFX that needed to be done, especially with Mr. Bachchan's legs, which means that every time when Mr. Bachchan, who plays the main protagonist in the film, every time that he's on screen, there had to be a VFX component that had to be factored in.
We sent the team to the director Bijoy's house, and one of the assistants, we made him sit on the wheelchair, so the wheelchair was already there because they were planning on what wheelchair to use for the film and stuff like that. So we just did a quick test, you know, with our cameras and with the wheelchair moving all around the house and stuff like that. And we took around a week to actually go ahead and, you know, work on the test. And we showed it to the director and Little Sir, and they were like really kind of, you know, taken aback in terms of that, you know, in a short time frame we actually delivered that. I mean, the effect was, he was pretty happy, you know, in terms of the effect as far as the amputation is concerned.
For me, the bottom line was that Amitabh Bachchan has no legs, as you see, and I wanted somebody to make it look real. See, the big problem for me in VFX is VFX looks like VFX, and when it looks like VFX, then for me that's the end of VFX.
Be it making sure that his legs don't move throughout the scene, and so we had to kind of tie his legs together. To making sure, you know, that every time that we finish a sequence, we had to take a 360 of the entire location.
Apart from his legs, the blast, the Kashmir, I mean, it's just, you know, today you can't think of a film without VFX. You know, but the difference is not VFX or not VFX. I think the difference is good VFX, which is almost invisible, and then not so good VFX, which is like terrible, and you know, this is VFX.
There were other aspects of the film, you know, which had, you know, visual effects sprinkled all around, you know, in terms of, you know, there was Kashmir sequences where there's, you know, simple green, you know, blue screens outside, and we had to go ahead and replace the environment. There was another, you know, chase towards the end of the film, you know, which had Farhan actually, you know, chasing on a bike, and you know, there we actually, you know, because it's very difficult to shoot him amongst cars, it was almost like a, you know, like a chase, and all the cars parking the camera were all digitally created, and you know, everything was matched for the lighting and texturing, the light just completely bang on. And that was a complicated sequence. The other ones were obviously, you know, there were lots and lots of muzzle flashes and splinters hitting the wall, you know, one of the action sequences.
Because the team of Viva was present throughout, and they had the schedule, so they were present throughout the shooting of each and every VFX. Even if the slightest amount of VFX, that they were there to make sure that, you know, everything was covered in the right way, so that their work doesn't get affected in any way. And in fact, towards the end of the post-production, there were certain new sequences that we had added, which we wanted to try and achieve, and I think the team managed to pull that off in record time, and they gave us something spectacular.
In Wazir, the first effect came up of the legs, and I just didn't like it. I think within half an hour or 40 minutes, I had Viral in my office with his little computer saying, let's fix this, and I think they worked overnight and fixed it next morning for the trailer. And I really like that. For me, that is what makes Viral who he is, and that's what makes us who we are. See, I believe in striving, and my cinema, whether it's Munna Bhai, whether it's Parinda, whether it's 1942 or Wazir or PK, I make one film in 4 or 5 years sometimes. So I strive for perfection in what I do.
Mr. Bachchan's legs, the texture of his legs every time, because there are some scenes where his legs are covered and the trousers are knotted, some scenes where his legs, the stumps can be seen. The stumps had to look consistent everywhere, and it had to look aged, it had to look weathered. So I think those sequences were the most difficult ones to achieve, and I think even the team of Reworld kept working, reworking to make sure it is correctly done.
Another challenge which came up was the Delhi, you know, the Janpath, you know, sequence wherein they shot everything out here in Bombay, you know, just outside Bombay in Kharghar, and we had to, you know, recreate a part of the Janpath, you know, with the India Gate and stuff like that. So all of that was obviously matte painted, and we took utmost care, you know, because what had happened was the foreground, you know, they shot the foreground, you know, the cars, etc., and Farhan in front of the car, they shot it here, and there were, you know, there were reflections on top of the car, you know, from some lights which were shot in Bombay, and we took like you know, utmost care in terms of the details, as far as, you know, once we add the matte painting behind the car, you know, then the lights in the matte painting should relate to the lights reflecting on the car, you know, so it just links up, you know, it just matches up to that.
If you see the gradient of the colors, we have not gone haywire. We have kept it in one mode, and like you said, the softer scenes have a certain warmth to it, but at the same time, it doesn't depart too much from what we kept that one palette, and we moved within that.
I always think that in Parinda, when I had the pigeons flying, I had to go to Kabutar Khana. I had to wait there for the pigeon. Every pigeon is real. I used to wait for pigeons. I used to look through the lens to see if the pigeons flew exactly the way I wanted them. And I used to go every morning to shoot, block traffic, block everything, put the dana there for the pigeons to come, and then hope that the pigeons will fly the way I did. And there was a shot of Jackie, and then it came to Anil, and then Anil turned around and the sun was setting and the camera kept moving, and down below the pigeons take a flight. You won't believe, we had four people. I used to move my hanky from behind the camera. The other guy moved his hanky because the guy who was down couldn't see the hanky. The guy on the building top there saw his hanky. He moved his hanky, and the guy down there blew a pataka, a little cracker for the pigeons to fly into the frame. Imagine I had to tie my hanky, that hanky, and bah! And the pigeons fly. And my camera reaches there and gets the pigeons fly.
A lot of films where the VFX cannot be seen. There is a lot of VFX in it, but you can't even see it. Wazir, I think, belongs to that.
Directors, you know, they're all, you know, involving us right from the script stage, and we're discussing on location. We're discussing on, you know, how the story should basically, you know, I mean, how visual effects can actually help the story and broaden the director's vision. You know, and that's how I personally come into picture. You know, I don't really go in as a VFX supervisor. I go in as a VFX director or a creative director, wherein I would live to film, you know, for months, and we would go ahead and just take the film to another level.
So all I say is, each time it's great fun. It's fun, it's, you know, you enjoy if you really push yourself harder and harder. It's like when I push Reba harder and harder, finally there's a film, the VFX, which is absolutely perfect.